Hello children, good morning to you. Now we are going to do with our next topic, that is write the differences between the following and two long question answers today. Understand, we are writing today two long question answers plus write the differences between. From which lesson? Globe and map. I am going to give you the note, but here just we are reading. How to write, I will explain. Write the differences between. How to write is our thing to do now. So our today's heading is first, write the differences between the following. Write the differences between the following. Okay, first one we take political and physical maps. Political and physical maps. This is the question. Under it we have to take here like this. Political map. This side we should take physical map. This is the question. Here let us write political map. This side we write physical map. So you can either draw the line in the middle. Okay, so underline it like this. You underline it like this. So the map which show different countries cities states etc. with their boundaries are called political we are going to draw a line here. the middle we are going to draw a line. So, political map. The maps which show different countries, cities, states, etc. with their boundaries are called political maps. Now, physical maps. The maps which show different physical features such as mountains, rivers, plains, plateaus, etc. Physical maps. So, this is the difference between political map and physical map. What are physical maps? The maps which show different physical features such as mountains, rivers, plains, plateaus, etc. are called physical maps. What is the difference between political map and physical map? Political map. The maps which show different countries, cities, states, etc. with their boundaries are called political maps. Physical maps. The maps which show different physical features such as mountains, rivers, plains, plateaus, etc. are called physical maps. Let us go to the second one. B. Cardinal and intermediate directions. Cardinal and intermediate directions. cardinal directions. Intermediate directions. The main directions. Such as east, west, north, south are called cardinal directions. Are called cardinal directions. Cardinal directions, the main directions such as east, west, north, south are called cardinal directions. Next, intermediate directions, the directions which lie between two main directions towards north and south are called intermediate directions. They are northeast, northwest, southeast, and southwest. So, intermediate directions, the directions which lie between two main directions towards north and south are called intermediate directions. They are northeast, northwest, southeast and southwest. So, cardinal directions, the main directions such as east, west, north, south are called cardinal directions. The intermediate directions, the directions which lie between two main directions towards the north and south are called intermediate directions. They are northeast, northwest, southeast and southwest. Third, नया पेंट स्केच। According to scale, sketch is not drawn according to scale. What is the difference between map and sketch? Map is drawn according to scale. Sketch is not drawn according to scale. Map is drawn according to scale. Sketch is not drawn according to scale. Last one in this, globe and map. The drawing of the earth on a flat surface such as wall, board, cloth, paper is called map. What is the globe? Is a true model of the earth. A true model of the earth is known as globe. Map, a drawing of the earth on a flat surface is such as wall, board, cloth, paper is called map. Okay, these are the four differences we have written. Now we are writing differences between. So over, we are writing long answer questions. Answer in detail. Next heading, we have answer in detail. Answer in detail. Our next heading is answer in detail. First, two questions we are writing in this. That's it. First one, what do you know about already you will get in the text message. What do you know about then color schemes used in maps. Used in maps. Answer. Maps are shaded with various colors to show varieties of information. Varieties of information. The color is a uniformly or commonly used in the map or blue to show water bodies, blue, green, brown, yellow. Blue color to show water bodies, green for plains, yellow, brown for hills, and mountains. Yellow for deserts. So what do you know about the color schemes used in the maps? Maps are shaded with various colors to show varieties of information. The colors which are uniformly used in the map are blue, green, brown, yellow, blue. Blue color used to show water bodies, green for plains, brown for hills and mountains, yellow for deserts. Maps are shaded with various colors to show varieties of information. The colors which are uniformly used in the map are blue, green, brown, yellow. Blue color to show water bodies, green for plains, brown for hills and mountains, yellow for deserts. Once again, what do you know about the color schemes used in the map? Maps are shaded with various colors to show varieties of information. The colors which are uniformly used in the map are blue, green, brown, yellow, blue color to show water bodies, green for plains, brown for hills and mountains, yellow for deserts and landforms, I can say. Now, second question. We are writing only two big questions today. Remaining tomorrow we are going to continue. Second question. What do you know about the give a short account of differences. What are the significances of conventional symbols? What are the significances of conventional symbols? So, what are the significance, means importance of conventional symbols? The signs and symbols are drawn on the map to show many types of information. They are drawn according to scale. They are drawn according to scale. They show features like boundaries. They show the features like boundaries, railway, river, railway lines, rivers, capitals, etc. Capitals, etc. They are accepted they are accepted by the whole world. Okay, so what are the significances of the conventional symbols? The signs and symbols are drawn on the map to show many types of information. They are drawn according to scale. They show the features like boundaries, railway line, rivers, capitals, etc. They are accepted by the whole world. The signs and symbols are drawn on the map to show many types of information. They are drawn according to scale. They show the features like boundaries, railway line, rivers, capitals, etc. They are accepted by the whole world. The signs and symbols are drawn on the map to show many types of information. They are drawn according to scale. They show the features like boundaries, railway line, rivers, capital, etc. They are accepted by the whole world. So, these two question answers I gave today. Understand? And four differences between. Here we stop our class. You get this matter in the typed form. So, this is all for today's social studies class. Thank you.